All right, guys, this is our first reaction to the 49ers offensive players to make the initial 53-man roster. Let's hop right in. Let's take a look and see how we feel about the first initial 53 on the offensive side of the football. So, quarterbacks, the 49ers opted to keep three. I think this was the smart move. It was the right move. Joshua Dobbs played too well. They like Brandon Allen. They like what he brings to the table. Not a bad problem to have three capable quarterbacks out there, obviously led by the chosen one, Brock Purdy. So I'm loving that the 49ers kept three. I really like that. Now, this is where we get our first shakeup. You've got Jordan Mason, Christian McCaffrey, Isaac Garendo. We found out Elijah Mitchell is on season-ending injured reserve. And no, it's not Cody Schrader that made the final roster. It was Patrick Taylor Jr. Now, this is a bit surprising in a certain aspect, and I'll tell you why. We didn't see a whole lot of Patrick Taylor because he was injured for a good portion of camp. He really didn't participate all that much in preseason. And so I didn't even expect that he was going to have a shot. However, I like Patrick Taylor. I like what I saw out of Patrick Taylor in training camp. I think he is an underrated running back who can play special teams. I kind of like the fact that he's on the roster. I'm really not upset at that. Like, I like Patrick Taylor. So to me, I'll take it. Obviously, the hope is that you can get Cody Schrader back on the practice squad and then continue to develop him, and he could be a guy that you rely on later on down the road. But Kyle Juszczyk, of course, makes the roster. So that's our first shakeup, but we're not done there. We have our wide receivers. The San Francisco 49ers keep seven, and this was something that I have been talking about with this 49ers wide receiver room for probably half the season. Is I believed there were six locks: Deebo Samuel, Brandon Ayuk, Ricky Pearsall, Juwan Jennings, Chris Conley, Jacob Cowing. Those were my locks. I had said it's up to Ronnie Bell to decide, obviously, or it was up to Ronnie Bell to convince the 49ers to keep seven wide receivers. I thought he had a good camp. He didn't have a good preseason, but I thought he had a good camp, and he made it. Ronnie Bell actually made it. So a little crazy, right? Because I think after the preseason game against the Raiders, a lot of people were like, oh yeah, Ronnie Bell's out of here. Ronnie Bell definitely hasn't earned too many fans this offseason, but I've been adamant in saying I thought he had a good training camp. I just think he had a not-so-good preseason. So he obviously offers a lot in special teams. He's a willing blocker. Just has to create more of a focus when it comes to being a wide receiver in the passing game. But the 49ers initially keep seven wide receivers. Then you have tight ends, George Kittle and Jake Tonges. This is the wildest room I think I've ever seen. I can't recall the last time I've seen a Kyle Shanahan situation where he only has two tight ends. I'm just like, whoa, he's got two tight ends. That's it. And it's none of the guys that we thought it was going to be. It's not Eric Saubert. It's not Braden Willis. It's not Cam Latu. It's not Mason Plyne. It's not Logan Thomas. It's Jake Tonges. Wow, what a surprise there. Now, listen, Jake Tonges, I've talked about him a couple times on this channel. I was impressed with him throughout the preseason and throughout training camp. I just didn't think that the 49ers would bring him on the active, because I assumed they thought that, yeah, we could just get this guy back onto the practice squad. Instead, they cut Latu, they cut Saubert, they cut Willis, and they keep Tonges. Wow, I think that's a bit of a shakeup, but I'm not upset at it. I think Tonge is a low key underrated player. That's just crazy. That I didn't have that on my bingo card at all. All right. So let's take a look at the offensive linemen now. So Jonathan Feliciano makes it. We'll come back to Feliciano. Nick Sakel makes it. No surprise there. No surprise with Jake Brendel, Banks, McKivitz, Burford, Moore, or Pooney. So obviously you can see who's not on the list. No Nugent, no Kingston, no Hubbard, no Parker. Those guys didn't make it. Feliciano makes it, but what is likely going to happen is he is going to be placed on injured reserve after being on the roster for a day or so, and then they revert him to IR so he can return in the middle of the season beyond 4 weeks, and they will likely re-sign some of these guys that they have cut. But that is your offensive line, and obviously you notice here there's no Trent Williams. Trent Williams is not listed, and that is because he is on the did not report list, which means he doesn't count as a active player against the roster. So interesting development, to say the least. Definitely wasn't exactly how I thought the 53 was going to shake out. I feel like on the offensive side, I felt like Zakel did a really good job. I thought he beat out Ben Bartsch as kind of that last guy in the offensive line pecking order. So I thought Zakel was going to make it. I assumed Hubbard was going to make it because they like to keep two tackles, a left swing tackle and a right swing tackle. They opted not to do that this year. The two tight ends thing. Definitely a surprise. I would say that's the biggest surprise. Ronnie Bell, not terribly surprised, even though I'm sure a lot of you guys will. And then I would say Patrick Taylor, also one of the bigger surprises out of all of this. The three quarterbacks, not much of a surprise there. But what do you guys think? This is your first look at the 49ers' first stab at the final 53. Again, we know with the Trent Williams thing and a couple players potentially going to IR, they might bring some other guys back. But this is our first look. This is what we got. So let me know, what are the biggest surprises that you see with this roster? At least on the offensive side. We're going to do a defensive video next, but let me know what you guys' thoughts are with your 49ers as of right now, 2024 offense. Let me know what you're thinking in the comments below. And as always, make sure to like and subscribe for more updates.